Dear Christians who support Black Lives Matter, but not queer rights. I am a biromantic demisexual woman and so member of the queer community. I am also a Christian and affirming of queer identities, including my own. I want to start by saying it took me a very long time to become affirming, and I know how complex the issue is. I understand that you take your faith seriously, and along with that, you respect and uphold the authority of Scripture. I understand that biblical exegesis on this subject is controversial, and you stand on the side of tradition. Secondly, I want to affirm my support for Black Lives Matter. In making this video, I do not want to take anything away from the Black Lives Matter movement or the work that so many people are doing towards ending the oppression of Black lives. I fully support the movement, and my aim in using it as a jumping off point to talk about queer issues is not meant to take anything away from it. But it is also Pride Month, and I think it's fair to talk about both. Recently, I have seen many Christians in my life advocate for Black Lives Matter on social media. I am thrilled that you are taking a stand for justice, and that you have so much of the Lord's compassion for those who are oppressed and outcast. But that said, these are the same people who, when I came out as both queer and affirming, told me that I was walking with the devil, who told me I was no longer a good influence on children and refused to let me engage with the children that I was mentoring at the time, even just to explain and to say goodbye. These are people who wouldn't let me hold a volunteer position in my church because I wouldn't sign and behave in accordance with their statement of belief, even though they don't require other volunteers to sign the same form. This video is my plea to those people. People who have so much compassion for the people of color who are losing their lives due to oppression and racism. This is my plea to you to recognize another group of people losing their lives to oppression, in this case, caused directly by the church and its theology. I am not only talking to the people who are obviously bigots, who picket and who say that homosexuals are cursed and unloved by God. I am talking to the good people who do their best to love gay people while saying, it's a sin if you act on it. I am here today to tell you, as a queer woman and a Christian, when it comes down to the heart of the message, it is not received much differently. This is not a question of acting on something, of a lustful sexual urge that can be resisted. I know that you have been taught this, that you see it as a sin like you see any sex outside of marriage. But I promise you, this issue is so much deeper than just a question of temptation. And that's why your theology hurts people. This is a question of love. Love is intrinsic to our understanding of the self, to our sense of humanity, to our sense of purpose, and to our understanding of the divine. Love is the purest part of humanity, the divine part, as God is love. It is the part that is truly selfless and holy. And there is a sense of identity that is tied to love. When you love someone, you feel as though you are designed to love them, that it is an essential part of your purpose to care for that person. When you tell a queer person that the way they love is unholy, you are telling them that the purest part of themselves, the part that is the deepest reflection of the God who is love, is wrong, and consequently, that their very understanding of goodness is inherently sinful. There is no way to hear this message except with devastation, shame, and self-hatred. There is a reason that when queer children experience family rejection, they are 8.4 times more likely to attempt suicide, 5.9 times more likely to experience depression, and 3.4 times more likely to turn to illegal drugs as a coping mechanism. Queer youth make up nearly 40% of the population of homeless teens, 40% of transgender adults reported having made a suicide attempt, and 90% of these before the age of 25. This is not a question of sexual sin. This is a question of a corrupt theology which leads only to death. I am privileged enough to have a support system of siblings and friends who have carried me through the hard time of coming out. I am lucky to have been in my mid-20s and self-sufficient. Even with that, there are days when I cannot get out of bed for the feelings of judgment, hopelessness, and despair born directly from the church and my family's reaction to my sexuality. When I came out, my church asked me how the church in general can love queer people while still upholding their traditional values. I'm here today to tell you that you can't, because your theology tells people that the most sacred and vulnerable part of themselves is evil. The part that loves selflessly, holy and beautifully is corrupt and sinful. Jesus says that we will know good teaching by its fruit. The fruit of your theology is self-harm, self-hatred, and death. It is barring an entire group of people from the house of God. It is driving God's children away instead of welcoming them close. When you stand up against police brutality, against the murder of innocents, I urge you to look into the mirror and to recognize your theology for what it is, a gun. I urge you to use the same compassion with which you see people of color and see the devastation the church has wrought on the queer community. We are crying out. We have been beaten, struck down, but we are not destroyed. I urge you to see us, to hear us. I urge you to stand up for all Black lives, not just those who are cis and straight. I urge you to fight for queer Asian lives, for queer Latinx lives, for queer Indigenous lives, for queer white lives, for all queer lives. God is the God of life, not death. So, dear Christians who support Black Lives Matter but not queer rights, choose life. Choose us. Isaiah 1:17. Learn to do what is right. Seek justice. Defend the oppressed. Take up the cause of the fatherless. Plead the case of the widow.